This is Nate Harrison, recording in winter of 2004. I'd like to talk about drums, or rather, about a particular drum beat. I'm sure you've heard it dozens of times before. It's been used as a rhythmic backdrop in everything from late 80s gangster rap to corporate America's recycling hip-hop forms to sell things like Jeeps and blue jeans to suburban America. In fact, just last week, I saw a TV commercial for a pharmaceutical company where this drum beat was used to promote some sort of purple pill. It's been used so much, I might argue it's now entered into the collective audio unconscious,
and did so about 3 or 4 years ago.
It's been somewhat glossed over now, but it has quite a history to it. This particular drum beat, or rather this break beat as it is more accurately called, or even more simply just break. Well, this particular break is called the Amen. The Amen break. Here's what it sounds like. Here, I'll play it again.
Here's what it sounds like.
In these cases, the one-bar loop of the Amen was used to create the rhythms. That is to say, it's a fairly straightforward use of the break. As time went on and samplers became more complex, so did their usage. In the UK, right around the time Straight Outta Compton is released, the rave scene there explodes, with musicians and DJs who used samplers in the Amen break to produce hardcore techno, raga jungle, and drum and bass. Jungle in particular, it being an amalgamation of reggae toasting, heavy bass lines, and high-speed breakbeats, centers its aesthetic almost entirely around the deconstruction of the Amen.
This was done by slicing the original 6-second sample into its individual drum hits. Each snare drum, each bass drum, the hi-hats, the crash cymbal.
Were plentiful and easily disseminated to their audiences via acetate test pressings, or dub plays as they're called. These one-off recordings, unlike mass-produced vinyl records that typically had to be pressed in quantities of 1,000 or more, were, and still are, back in the morning, get a dub plate cut that afternoon, and have a DJ play it to a crowd that night.
Indeed, the Amen break appears quite adaptable to a range of music genres and tastes. What it it sounds like. Here's what it sounds like.